Hello everyone, my name is Afonso and in this video I'm gonna show you how I built this 36V 12Ah battery. I bought this kit off AliExpress, it costed me 60 euros and it comes with pretty much anything you need to assemble this pack. You've got the support for the e-bike, you got the case, you've got the cell holders, you've got nickel strips, you have all the connectors, key and the barrel, and you got the screws and a small LED indicator. That's pretty much all you need. These are the cells we're working with, LG HE2. These are 2500 mAh in capacity and they can discharge up 20 amps continuous. Let's start right up with placing the cells. In the above picture you can see in red the top side connections and in blue the bottom side connections. The connections and the cell placement can be done in a different way, but this is the best way I have found to minimize the resistance between series connections and the usage of nickel strips. Once everything is done, we can start to tighten these cell holders. And here we go. And now we can start laying out the nickel strips on top of these cells. But first, let's check every single cell voltage, making sure that they are closely matched. In our case, pretty much every single cell is at 3.47 volts, so we are good to go. This is the amount of nickel strips we have to work with, that came with our kit. Now we can start cutting up the nickel strips, following our diagram. This makes it pretty easy now to go through all these connections and cut the nickel strips to the size we want. You can check it out here. Basically, we are trying to mimic each of the colors on each of the sides with a nickel strip. After the first layer, we gotta cut up a second one and place it perpendicular so that we make sure we got a very even connection to all the cells. As you can see, these nickel strips are in a diagonal fashion, specific for this purpose, but to make sure you have a good connection to the parallels and the series connections, we make sure we cross them over. And you can see this is the bottom side connections. After this is all done, we can start spot welding them in. First one goes in, on the bottom side. And we're good. Now repeat the process for all the nickel strips. You can see I lay them down. If you can, make sure to use gloves and clean up the connections, the nickel strips and the cells so that we got a very good surface to spot weld over. Making sure you use gloves will prevent oils from your hands to going into the cells and ruining your weld. Here is a BMS, you can see I got a Jabaida. Here are the cell connections. On the bottom side I had to use a thicker nickel strip because I ran out of the stock one they sent me. The only connections left are the negative and the positive. And this is exactly how I'm going to do it. You can see here. Now we just got to spot weld the negative to the battery, do the same with the positive. Use the same method here, two nickel strips, one on top of the other. Crossed over so that we make sure we got a very even connection to all the cells. Now I'm spot welding in the balance wires. This is a new method I am just testing out. Basically, we just spot weld the wire directly to the cells. And we place a bit of silicon afterwards so we make sure that any vibrations don't take this spot weld loose. I'm going in from the negative to the most positive, jumping every other balance wire because I'm doing one side at a time. You can see here. After the cell taps are done, we could go ahead and test our BMS. We basically connect first the negative, then the balance leads. We check out our app to see if everything is working okay. And you can see everything is fine. Just placing a bit of insulation in between the fiberglass sheet on the sides. Now I'm just closing everything up with Kapton tape. These are the connections to the outside of the battery. You can see I've split the terminals into two to split the power also. I've done this with the positive and negative. After everything is connected, we can test fit our battery inside the box. Make sure you don't split a cable or a wire while doing this. And in our case, everything fits, just very snug, but it fits. The only thing I didn't record was making the charge connections, as this battery pack has a separate charging port. You need to place a fuse in series with these connections to make sure we don't burn anything. And also the battery level indicator. But these are all pretty simple to assemble. All that is left is the sticker on top of it, after we have closed everything. We check the battery all around to make sure it's closed up good. I also shook it well to see if anything was loose inside. We don't want anything loose inside the battery. And that's it, we tested out the lock. This is the bottom piece, everything is connected. All that was left to do was making the output cable for the controller. The last thing we need to do is to fully charge the battery. Make sure you follow this process, as if something goes wrong, it will be doing the charge. Now we just need to do a full discharge, see if the battery capacity is within our expectation, and we get our battery fully assembled. Thank you so much for watching. Comment down below, like the video, and I'll see you next time.